This is the upright drill press. The main components of the upright drill press are the head, the column, the work table, and the base. The column, of course, is our main backbone of the machine. It provides a lot of rigidity and support, as well as the base right here at the bottom. The base will also enable to move this work table, which we'll demonstrate in just a minute. We can move the work table out of the way and put a taller piece of steel or part can be bigger so that you can get something larger on this drill press to work with. The other pieces of the drill press are the variable speed drive, which is located here. By turning this crank, you can get more spindle speed. You have an on-off switch, a depth stop that's adjustable, and it has graduations that are printed right here, so you can actually gauge how deep you're going. Now, granted, none of this is accurate because it's just printed. It's not engraved, and it's not calibrated necessarily. You have your quill handle here, so it'll retract and advance the quill. You also have a table crank here and a table lock, so we can loosen the lock and crank and move up and down. We can also spin this out of the way, as I talked about previously. And as long as nothing's heavy on here, if it's too heavy back here, then it might tip over. So you always want to make sure you have nothing heavy if you're going to spin this table, work table all the way to the back so you can put a larger piece on. When you get it in position, you always lock the table clamp down. One thing important to remember with safety on this piece of equipment is to always wear safety glasses. One operator should be running this piece of equipment, no more than one operator. And your vise can't be to the right of the operator. Your spindle turns clockwise, so if the material is a type of material that tends to grab onto the tool, this can spin towards the operator and injure the operator. So you always, when you're drilling anything on a drill press, make sure that your vise is towards the column on the left side. That way, if it does grab, it's not going to go anywhere and it's not going to injure anyone. All right, we can cut spindle on here. Our spindle speed is indicated right here in RPM, revolutions per minute. We can speed that up with our variable speed handle here. Slow it down, of course. And when you cut it off, you always want to let it come to a complete stop. Never put your hand on the chuck or the tool to try to stop it. And that's the drill press.